In this video, we will be talking about how to add multimedia to our PowerPoint presentations, such as hyperlinks, sound, and video. We can insert sounds and movies from the Insert ribbon. When we select the Insert Sound icon, we have options for playing a track from a CD, recording some audio, or inserting a sound file. When we select Insert Sound, we can look at the Files of Type dropdown and see the files that we can insert into our PowerPoint presentation. The most common files you will find online will probably be MP3 or WAV files. Archive.org is a great source for public domain audio files. I am looking at the page for the famous Martin Luther King Jr. speech. Notice that there are a number of sound file types that I can download, such as MP3 or WAV. Notice how the WAV file is quite a bit larger than the MP3 file because WAV uses a lossless compression technique, while MP3 is a lossy compression format, and this file has had a reduction in fidelity, so the file size is much smaller. If I click on the MP3 link, it immediately starts to play the file in my web browser, so I want to make sure I right-click on the file and save it to my computer. When I insert the sound file into PowerPoint, it immediately asks me if I want the sound file to play automatically or play when I click on it. It also creates a speaker icon for my sound file. If I do not like the icon it has created, I can go to the Sound Tools option menu and select Hide During Show to hide the icon while in my presentation, or I can change the icon to a different image by right-clicking on the icon and selecting Change Picture. I think I want to change this icon to a picture of Martin Luther King, so I will open Firefox, find his image on Wikipedia, and save the image to my computer. Then I can right-click on the sound icon, select Change Picture, and select the file I previously saved. When I click on my sound in Slideshow View, I can hear my sound file. I can elect to hide my sound file image or have my sound file loop. One option that may seem confusing is the Max Sound File Size text box. If my sound file was a WAV file and smaller than this size, PowerPoint would embed my sound file in my presentation. Otherwise, the sound file is a separate file that I need to keep with my presentation when I copy my presentation to another computer. If I want to use just a portion of this sound file, I can edit the sound file in a sound editor such as Goldwave. Goldwave is a great shareware program available from www.goldwave.com. Goldwave allows me to select just a portion of the audio file that I can save as a new MP3 file. When we add a sound file or video file into PowerPoint, it automatically handles the file as an animation. If we click on the custom animation icon on the animations ribbon, we can see the animation that was created when we inserted our file. We can even use the sound file as part of more complex animations, using the custom animation pane to start, stop, or pause our sound file. Anymore, when we think of video, we think of the web, specifically YouTube. We have two different ways we can add a YouTube video to our presentation. We can add a hyperlink to our video by pasting the URL into our presentation and pressing Enter. Unfortunately, any time we are offline or on a slow network connection, we would be unable to play our video. We can right-click on the hyperlink we added to remove, edit, or test the hyperlink. We can download a video and include it with our presentation, so the video will work even when we are offline, but this will be a little bit more complicated. There are many different ways to download and convert these videos, and in the past, YouTube has blocked certain websites from making this possible, so any particular method may not last for long. If I need to use a video in the classroom, I use www.keepvid.com. When I first access the Keepvid website, I can right-click on my toolbar in Firefox and turn on my bookmarks toolbar. I can then drag the Keepvid bookmarklet to my bookmarks toolbar. A bookmarklet is a bookmark that contains JavaScript code, which can add features to the websites that we use, such as in this case, allowing us to download videos. Now that I have my Keepvid bookmarklet in my bookmarks toolbar, I can go back to my YouTube video, click on my bookmarklet, and it will take me to a page with download links for my video. Usually the page works the first time, but this time I had to reload it before I saw my links. Notice that the files are in FLV format. While I am downloading this file to my computer, let's talk about video files. If I look at the files of type list when I try to insert a movie into PowerPoint, FLV is not listed as one of the supported file types. So I will need to convert my video to a different format that PowerPoint does actually understand. Video file formats can be pretty tricky. Many video file formats are container files, so the file extension does not necessarily tell you what kind of file the file actually is. The common AVI file format is an example of this, with dozens of different internal formats. These internal formats use different codecs, which is short for coder-decoder. A video file may require a specific codec for playback, and when you take your video file to another computer, you may find that this computer does not have this codec installed. You are generally best off if you prepare your presentation for the lowest common denominator. I can use software on my computer to convert the file, or I can use a website to convert the file for me. For free software, we can use programs like Super, available at www.ewritesoft.com. Or we can use Avidemux, available at www.avidemux.org. For a free website that will convert our videos, we can use www.media-convert.com. Media Convert allows us to upload our videos and then select a format for conversion that we can then use in PowerPoint. First, we browse for our video file that we downloaded. Notice that the website recognized that we are going to upload an FLV file. Then we select the output format. I generally convert the videos I use in PowerPoint to MPEG-1 format. This is a very old and common video format that is generally very widely supported, though it may result in larger video files. I have made the mistake of trying to use this website during prime time on a holiday, so it is not working for me right now, but generally the website works well during the day and early morning. So I think instead we will use a video that I have previously converted using this website. I will click on the Insert ribbon, click on Movie, and find the video file I wish to import. Since it is an MPEG file and compatible with PowerPoint, I can easily insert it into my presentation. I am going to elect to have my video start when I click on it. The movie can be treated as an image and resized using the adjustment handles. In the Movie Tools Options ribbon, I can choose to have my movie loop or rewind when it has finished playing. I can look at the custom animation pane and change the settings for my movie as part of a more complex animation. When I click on Slideshow View, I can see my video play in my presentation.